Leave me alone.
I will never leave you.
What do you want from me?
Nothing, Bela. I want nothing from you.
Why won't you leave me alone?
I want to help you.
Help me?
I want to give you something.
What?
What you want. More than you could possibly dream of.
What is that? No. Leave me alone. Please leave me alone.
5 minutes, Mr. Lugosi.
Thank you.
Time to take my medicine. When I was playing Dracula on the stage, my admirers were women.
Women?
Go away! There were men, too. Escorts the women had brought with them. For reasons only the dark subconscious knew. In order to establish a subtle sex intimacy. Contact. In order to cling and feel the sensuous thrill of protection. Men did not come of their own volition. Women did. Came and came back again. Knew an ecstasy dragged from the depths of unspeakable things. Came and came back again and again. But that was a long time ago. 1930.
I am Dracula.
There Are Such Things, by Mark McDonnell and Stephen McNichol. Performed by Stephen McNichol, Mark McDonnell, Julie Duncanson, and Gavin Mitchell.
I am Dracula. I bid you welcome.
Again?
I bid you welcome.
Again, hit welcome.
I bid you welcome.
Okay, that'll do. Now, the wolves howl, point to the window, and...
Listen to them, the children of the night. What music they make.
Why, yes.
And cut! Cut! Carl! Oh, Jesus! Okay, where's the crazy crowd?
Over here, playing pinochle with Mr. Van Sloan. Why? You want to make something of it? Drunken asshole!
Pardon me, Mr. Browning.
Get your fat keister over here and switch this camera off before I knock you on your ass!
Okay, boys, that's a print. Set up for the next shot.
Mr. Browning.
Oh, shit, Bella. What do you want?
Is that a print?
Yeah. You got a problem?
You don't think it was a bit over the top?
God damn it, Bella. Everybody stop what you're doing. Mr. Lugosi would like to take a moment out of our extremely punishing schedule to ask you all if he was a bit over the top. He's played the part of the undead count for over 3 years on Broadway, but it's taken until now to inquire if his performance was satisfactory. Well, boys, was it over the top?
No.
Thank you for your time, gentlemen. Do carry on. There, Bela, straight from the horse's mouth. If you want my opinion, Mr. Cheney would have done it better. God rest him. Now, if you'll excuse me, our leading lady has appendicitis. Come on, guys, keep it moving. Oh, yeah, telegram for you.
Thank you, Mr. Browning. Want you should tour Dracula, Pacific Coast, stop. Offering $750 a week plus percentage, stop. Movie will prove great publicity, stop. Here's to ya, stop. Henry Duffy.
What an opportunity.
No, never. Not at any price. When I am through with this picture, I hope to never hear of Dracula again. I cannot stand it.
Oh, come now. That's a little harsh.
I do not intend that it shall possess me. No one knows what I suffer from this role.
Oh, I do.
Excuse me, Mr. Lugosi?
Yes.
Can I have your autograph, please?
Gladly. You have a pen?
Yeah.
Thank you. What is your name?
Oh, it's not for me. It's for my sister.
When I played Dracula on the stage, women wrote me letters. Oh, what letters women wrote me.
Young girls?
Yes. From 17 to 30. Letters of horrible hunger.
You would throw all that away?
And what is your sister's name?
Leslie.
To the beautiful Leslie. My kiss is the kiss of death. Your servant, Bela Lugosi. There you are.
Ah, that's great. Thank you.
Leslie! Get your faggoty ass over here before I fire it out the goddamn window!
Excuse me.
Faggoty ass.
The woman of America are unsatisfied, famished, craving sensation, even though it be the sensation of death. It is woman who bear the race in bloody agony.
In the history of living terror, one man stands out as the prince of evil, Dracula.
Rats, rats, millions of rats.
Suffering is a kind of horror. Blood is a kind of horror. Therefore, women are born with a predestination to horror in their very bloodstream.
This is the nightmare of Dracula. The story of a maniac and a vampire who lived on human blood.
Dracula? Oh, what's he done to you? Tell me.
He came to me. He opened his vein in his arm and made me drink.
It is women who love horror, gloat over it, feed on it. Are nourished by it, shudder and cling and cry out, and come back for more.
From beyond the grave, to thrill and chill you, Bela Lugosi is the master of horror, Dracula!
Drinks all round! Drinks for everybody!
Excuse me, Mr. Lugosi. Can I take these empty glasses?
Certainly, my dear. Thank you. Ah, the mother tongue.
Is that Hungarian?
Indeed.
What are they saying?
They're saying, Lugosi is eternal.
Wow. Well, Mr. Lugosi, sir, may I just say what a big fan I am?
Why, thank you, my dear.
I've seen Dracula 3 times.
Does it not terrify you?
Sure! That's why I love it.
It is women who love horror.
Can I get you some more wine?
Thank you.
White or red?
Ah, red. I only drink red wine. I like it because it is the color of blood.
Oh, gee. You're fantastic.
One moment. Who is that?
Where?
Over there, by the pillar. The old man with the mustache.
I can't see him.
Yes, you can. He's there, wearing a long black coat. He's gone.
He must have gone into the John.
Yes, you're probably right. Good health.
Can I ask what's the next picture you'll be doing?
My next picture will be Frankenstein. And I shall play Dr. Frankenstein, the man who created a monster.
The spider spinning his web for the unwary fly.
I'm sorry, Bella. It's true. Limley Jr. wants you to play the monster.
But any half-wit extra could play it. Anybody can moan and grunt. I am an actor.
I know. I've been writing the script with you in mind. Believe me, I have fought for it. But he won't budge. He wants us to shoot a couple of test scenes.
Never!
You know the score, Bella. We're both in the same boat. It's Universal's ball, and they can play with it however they like. They want you to meet Jack Pierce. For a makeup test.
That pompous ass couldn't get any worse.
Look, Bella, you're riding high. I understand how you feel, but let's not piss him off. Do the test, huh?
Hey, Rofield! Now remember what is its got, Bella. Just rise up from the sled slowly. Imagine it's incredibly painful to move at all. That's it. And action!
The lizard eyes were made of rubber, as was his false head. I made his arms look longer by shortening the sleeves of his coat. His legs were stiffened by steel struts and two pairs of trousers. His large feet were the boots asphalt spreaders wear. His fingernails were blackened with shoe polish. The whole outfit weighed about 70 pounds.
Oh, no, no. I want my face to be seen.
Come to me. Don't fight me. Come, let me help you. Let me take you away.
No! Enough!
Good! Good! Bella, what is it? You okay?
Enough is enough! Ivano, my close-up is magnificent. But that's it. I'm sorry, Robert. I was a star in my own country. I will not be a scarecrow over here! Ah! I can't walk in these shoes!
Yeah, Dad. I'm taking Lugosi and Flory off Frankenstein. Why? Because the test is a disaster. Lugosi's behaving like a jerk, that's why. Yeah, and Flory's got the script all wrong. Don't worry, wait till you hear this. James Whale was eager to come on board, and he's trying to find someone to play the monster. Yeah, an unknown maybe. Someone more versatile.
Lugosi, would you describe yourself as typecast?
Circumstances made me the theatrical personality I am, which many people believe is also part of my personal life. My next picture, Murders in the Rue Morgue, will continue to establish me as a weird, horrible creature.
Oh, I can't wait, Mr. Lugosi.
As for my own feelings on the subject, I've always felt I would rather play, say, comedy than Lon Chaney types of things. Frankenstein, it is not a star part. Anyone could play it.
What about Dracula?
I will never play the role of Dracula again.
It's moving. It's alive. It's alive. It's moving. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive! It's alive! It's alive! In the name of God! Now I know what it feels like to be God!
Frankenstein establishes Boris Karloff as the one important candidate who has arisen to take on the mantle of the late Lon Chaney.
Boris who?
Karloff, Bella. Boris Karloff.
Because of his restraint, his intelligent simplicity of gesture, carriage, voice, and makeup, Karloff has truly created a Frankenstein monster.
Yes. But what about Murders in the Rue Morgue?
Forget Murders in the Rue Morgue.
Karloff's Christmas present. Yes, the King of Horror.
King of Horror?
I heard he was a truck driver.
Mr. Boris Karloff today received an early Christmas present from Universal Studios, the makers of Frankenstein. They gave him a star contract. Well done, Boris.
But what about murders in the Rue Morgue?
It's a bomb, a disaster. Lugosi can't carry a picture on his own. But don't worry, Dad, I've got a great idea.
Mr. Lugosi, Mr. Karloff, big smiles, please.
Oh, I want to get away. People, thousands of them, clinging always to certainties and terrified by the unknown. They live like ants.
They live like cattle.
I must get away somewhere I can be free.
Great, gentlemen. And just hold those tankards towards me. That's great. And how is the beer?
It's brown and it's wet. It reminds me of home in England.
I don't like him.
I don't usually drink beer. I prefer red wine.
So Universal have finally done it and signed up the two kings of horror for a three-picture deal. Are you looking forward to working together?
Certainly. It will be quite an experience, and I'm sure the work will be most challenging.
Yes, Bela's right. I think we'll have a lot of fun.
Big smiles, please.
So tell me, how do you guys get along?
Oh, horrifically.
Countless years I have rotted in the darkness. How I dream to kill not you, but your soul. Slowly. Ah, shit!
Oh, I'm so terribly sorry.
Okay, cut it! Reset, we'll go again. Wardrobe, get it down for Mr. Lugosi!
For God's sake, Boris, this is intolerable. It's hard enough trying to act while you sit there drinking tea, let alone spilling it all over the place. There are two of us in this scene, don't forget.
But only one of us is in shot, dear boy.
Yes, me. I'm sick of your tricks, do you hear? No more. Constantly trying to undermine me with your hot tea and muff
cakes. Relax, Bela. I assure you I'm not up to anything. It's 3 o'clock in the afternoon and I always have my tea. It's a custom in England, that's all. Please don't be suspicious. I shan't do it again.
Very well. I apologize. I'm sorry, Boris.
There, isn't it better to be friends?
Yes.
After all, we've got another two pictures to get through.
Here's a change of pants, Mr. Lugosi.
Thank you. Excuse me.
Would you like another cup of tea, Mr. Karloff?
Oh, that would be lovely, my dear. Poor Bela. I was only pulling his leg. He's so serious.
For a long time, people think I am aloof, distant, temperamental, mysterious. I am none of these things. I am embarrassed, not confident of my English. In the early days, I learned my parts for not by hearing them. Always, I am word perfect. There is a way I can change your face. It's not what you would call plastic surgery, but...
I don't care. Do it.
First, you must do me a small favor.
What?
I would think it's in your line.
What's my line?
Torture and murder.
That's not my line, that's your line.
No, Boris, what's my line is your line.
What?
The script. I say it's in your line, and you say, what's my line?
Oh, yes, sorry. I thought... never mind. Do you want to go back?
No, just pick it up.
What's my line?
I told you, I see. God, Boris, I think sometimes you tease me insane on purpose.
Oh, why do you take it all so seriously? Why don't you just laugh your way through this nonsense like I do?
Because, Boris, I am an actor, not a truck driver.
That's funny. Jimmy Whale used to call me that, too.
Mr. Karloff, Mr. Lugosi, Mr. Friedlander would like you on set.
Oh, well, on with the motley. Here comes the heavy.
I wish you wouldn't always say that.
I'm waiting for you. Come.
You okay, Mr. Lugosi?
Yes. It's my leg. I think I've pulled something.
You want a doctor?
No. I'll be all right. I am professional. Times change, but film does not. Preserved in emulsion, we shall live forever. Dead... yet alive.
Yes, you begin to see. Come, embrace me.
No, go away. We change, from Jekyll to Hyde, William Henry Pratt becomes...
Karloff the Uncanny, back from the dead to thrill you.
And Bela Ferencváros Blasco becomes...
Bela Dracula Lugosi. That old ham? Nah, we can't use him. He's too temperamental, too foreign. Hey, is Peter Lorre free?
Too temperamental, too foreign. Once I would bite, but now I am bitten.
Cursed.
One night, I hear a waitress whisper.
There goes Lugosi, the unemployable.
There are far worse things awaiting man than death.
The pain, the agony, shooting pains in my legs.
We can do a deal.
Please, leave me alone.
Okay, Mr. Lugosi, you can put your shirt back on.
What can you do, Doctor? Anything to stop the pain. I can't bear it. I can't work.
Oh, you're doing a picture.
No.
I like dog pictures. They should make more dog pictures. Dog pictures make a lot of money.
Doctor!
I'm going to prescribe 5 milligrams of morphine. I'll give you a shot right now. Roll up your sleeve, please. Okay. Do you know Rin Tin Tin?
Oh, true apothecary. Thy drugs are quick. Thus, with a kiss, I die. I feel my pain evaporate. I shut my eyes, and I am in Hungary. I am Romeo. I am dead. The applause, it bears me up, high above the audience. The applause carries me up, up through the clouds. The moon is full and bright. As I flow towards it, something flies out and surprises me. As I fall, I look up. It is a bat.
Welcome to my house. Enter freely, and of your own will.
Not again. Always following me. Let me alone.
It is time for us to talk.
No! Leave me alone.
I will always be with you.
What are you?
A glance at that mirror should tell you.
You cast no reflection.
There is only you. You know who I am. You've always known.
No!
7 years, Bela.
I know you.
Just talk to me. I will listen.
Not yet. I have more, much more to give.
I will be here, as I have always been. The dark genie in your... little bottle. Summon me whenever you wish. I can help you. I will help you.
How can you help me? To go away!
You will never be rid of me.
Good evening, Miss Lugosi. Oh, new roller skates?
Yes, my dear. The old ones fell to pieces.
I bet you go pretty fast on those, huh?
Like lightning.
Oh, gee, you're crazy. Well, here you are, sir. Your cigars and the 11 p.m. edition of the L.A. Times. Hot off the press.
Excellent.
Oh, and you're in it, too.
What do you mean? I just bumped into the old lady while skating in the park. She said she was fine.
Oh, no, no, Mr. Lugosi. Nothing like that. The Regina Cinema up in Beverly Hills is showing Dracula, Frankenstein, and Son of Kong in a triple bill.
Really?
And it's a huge hit. The cinema's packed out every night, apparently. It says they're queuing around the block.
The blood is the life.
After the phenomenal success of the re-release of Dracula and Frankenstein, New Universal have announced their next picture will be Son of Frankenstein. And it seems those masters of horror, Karloff and Lugosi, will be together again to terrify us out of our wits.
Half it! Whatever we agreed to pay Lugosi, half it! He's in no position to refuse. Who is he anyway? A nobody, a schmuck, and tell the director to get all the ghosty stuff in the can in 1 week.
Those goddamn sons of bitches. I'll show them.
Thank you, Mr. Lee. I won't let you down.
And don't worry, Bela. You're gonna love Igor. It's a hell of a role.
Igor? But it's not even in the script.
Screw the script. Tear it up. I'm writing this picture. Don't worry. Like I told you, Igor is a hell of a part.
You want it in makeup, Mr. Lugosi?
What a triumph. Igor, that broken-necked, snaggle-toothed, grave-robbing misfit. Dracula, I'm free of it at last.
I wouldn't pay, Tony.
Igor. God, he was cute.
Who are you?
My name is Igor.
I'm going to hand you over to the police.
No, not that.
Why?
They not want dead man. I am dead.
What are you talking about?
You see my neck? They hanged me, snapped my neck, thought I was dead, and they cut me down.
Why did they hang you?
I robbed graves, they said.
And cut! Excellent! Now let's swing round for Basil's close-up.
Mr. Lee, was that a print?
Sure was!
You don't think it was a little over the...
Bela, it was great! Believe me, I love what you're doing with Igor. That voice, it's incredible.
Well, thank you, Mr. Lee. I've been working very hard on it.
Listen, I've written you some more dialogue for tomorrow's scenes. Bela, screw the studio. I'm going to keep you on this picture to the last day of filming. And that's a promise.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Lee. Thank you.
He's alive.
He's my friend. He does things for me.
Oh, dear. Our secret's out, Bela.
Cut! Cut! Right, you guys crack me up.
Bela.
Go away. I'm doing fine.
Bela.
I feel better.
Son of Frankenstein is a knockout.
I feel stronger.
A star-spangled horror epic.
I feel invigorated.
Bela Lugosi is quite horrible.
I look forward to seeing all my fans in my next picture.
So, Mr. Karloff, are we to understand that you will not be playing Frankenstein's monster again?
I'm afraid not. You see, I owe him so much that I owe him a little respect, a little rest.
But, Kurt, I can't. I refused 10 years ago, and I refuse now.
But it's not the same now. It's more of a challenge. Mm. Do well in this, and you don't have to do the new Dracula picture. Oh. You can write your own ticket. Bela, I wrote it with you in mind.
You did?
Hmm. Look, just take it home and read it, and I'll call you in the morning.
All right, I will. I'm grateful, Kurt. Really, I am.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Don't do this, Bela. I warn you. It's a trap.
10 years ago, I turned the part down, and now I can't afford to. I have been punished enough. Now I make amends.
So, Bela, what do you think?
Oh, Kurt, you must get me this part. You are right. It is more of a challenge, and it makes sense. Igor's cunning brain is now in the body of the Frankenstein monster. It is more of a part, no longer just a grunting imbecile. Oh, and the dialogue. What dialogue? A real meaty opportunity. Karloff could never play it. I shall play the monster. Tell them, Kurt. Tell them.
He'll do it.
Good work, Kurt. Now then, where's my checkbook? I think you can afford that new car.
Keep your blood money. I'll buy myself some roller skates.
Ah, good morning, Mr. Lugosi.
Good morning, Mr. Pierce.
Well, 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 here we are. Got you at last, yeah? If you care to sit down, we can begin. We'll start with the scar. Get it out of the way. Chin up.
Ah, it burns. What do you do to me, Pierce?
Relax. The burning will ease when it dries. You know, Mr. Karloff would sit in this chair for hours and not a word of complaint from his lips. A true gentleman. Chin up. He understood the futility of actors trying to escape their fate at the hands of the makeup man. He's doing so well now. He deserves it. Chin up!
Ouch! That really stings!
Oh, don't be such a baby.
It will be worth it. Keep telling yourself. It will be worth it.
It won't.
The pain, the agony, the humiliation. But what an opportunity. At last, I played the monster.
Better than Karloff.
Better than Karloff.
Better than Janey.
Better than Janey. The monster shall live again, and I shall triumph.
Once I had the strength of 1,000 men. Now, it's all gone. I'm sick. Dying.
Kurt. Kurt, why are they laughing?
Jeez, Bela, you want them to catch us?
The villagers tried to kill me. They burned the laboratory. Dr. Frankenstein perished in the
Oh, God. But they are laughing.
Bela, this is a private screening.
XX only.
Those futile little mortals. Do you hate them?
Sell this crap.
Oh, God. Did I write this?
Is it me or is it your script? Why do they laugh?
Quiet. If they catch us, they'll fire my sorry ass off the lot before you can say Frankenstein was the meat man. God, what have I done?
But why do they laugh, Kurt? Why?
Come on. I can't take much more of this. I'm sorry. Come on. Let's get drunk. Come on.
Oh, no. I don't believe this.
Who does he think he is? Romeo?
I think we've seen enough.
Okay, Charlie, kill it. This is a disaster. A Frankenstein monster talking in this funny Hungarian. Oh, God, I can see the trades now. More goulash than ghoul. It's a mockery. It's absurd.
Absurd, huh? The picture's called Frankenstein Meets the Wolfman, for crying out loud.
Exactly, that's my point. These pictures are getting sillier and sillier.
So, what are we gonna do about our Hungarian monster?
Cut my dialogue? You can't. My performance will be ruined. I'll sue.
I don't think so. Look at your contract and please don't forget the shooting days we lost as a result of your back problem.
The makeup and the costume were heavy. Can I help it if I get sick?
Listen, Bob, they're sick and they're sick. Now, I don't know how you did things in the old days, but this is New Universal and your little habit hasn't gone unnoticed.
But I'm sick. Go away. It's only medicine.
So you're sick. Well, if you want to work here, you better get well soon. Understand?
Yes, I understand.
Good. We'll say no more about it.
Thank you.
One more thing.
Yes?
About the new Dracula picture.
Carefully now.
Yes?
We're giving it to Cheney Jr. so you can stop sending your photographs to my secretary.
Cheney Jr.? That thug?
Yeah, well, that thug is a new master character creator or something.
But I am Dracula.
Good boy.
Look, Bela, I'll lay it on the line. The studio feels that you're a little long in the tooth to play a 900-year-old vampire.
But I'm only 50.
Come off it, Bela. You're 61. I'm sorry. We'll try and find you something more suitable, smaller, more within your range.
You mean bit parts?
No. Cameos, Bela. Character cameos.
I see.
Good. You know it makes sense. We only want what's best for the studio. And yourself, of course.
They are trying to destroy you. Drag you kicking and screaming into the sunlight. You belong in the darkness with me.
I'm tired.
In sleep, Bela.
Yes, sleep.
It's it. Sleep.
Those bastards cannot hurt me when I sleep.
No.
I have my nightmares for that. Fractured memories of the war. Once an infantry captain, I have seen and done many terrible things.
Like what?
Once I hide under a pile of fresh corpses to escape death. Those dead eyes in the darkness, I see every time I close my eyes.
It's nothing.
All right. All right. I'm a hangman for a day, watching the crazy, jerking dance of death, knowing I have the power to end life, the thrill, then the shame.
Then the guilt.
My three war wounds.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Holy Jesus! I swear, Bela, you are not going to regret this. I'm delighted to have a star of your magnitude under contract. And I mean a star, no shit.
Well, it's nice to be a star again, Mr. Katzman.
Call me Sam. Hell, I know we don't pay the kind of money that the majors do, but what we lack in quality, we make up for in quantity.
It is good to be busy.
That's the spirit. God, you're a spunky son of a bitch.
Thank you.
Okay, let's cut the crap. Here's what we're gonna do. We'll knock out one picture a week with all the pre-publicity and your name on the poster. We'll make a killing, Bela.
A killing, yes.
And just get a load of these titles. There's something for everyone. The Invisible Ghost. Creepy. Black Dragons. Mysterious. The Corpse Vanishes. Whoa. Spooks Run Wild. No shit. It's a hit. They won't let me put that on the poster. I'm just kidding. Then Barry at Midnight, which says it all. Oh, and The Ape Man. A great part. Bela, you turn into a monkey.
A monkey?
Yeah, it's a sensation. Then there's Ghost on the Loose, a scream. Voodoo Man, very you. And last, but by no means least, Return of the Ape Man.
Am I a monkey again?
Hell no, we got George Izuko for that. And at a snip. That crazy bum's so hard up, he'll do anything.
Poor bastard.
So here it is, your contract. A star contract awaiting your signature.
You have a pen?
Sure. Hey, hey, don't you want to sign in blood? Oh, boy, we are going to make a killing.
A killing.
And you are the victim.
Kill me, Katzman. Hammer those 9 tawdry nails in the coffin of my career.
Rest in peace, Bela.
Oh, what a mess I make of things.
No, not you.
No, not I. When you sign on the dotted line, it becomes the most important project of your life. No, it's this business.
The producer.
Yes, you are right. In pictures, a true villain is often the script, but always producers. Enough. If pictures are done with me, then I am done with pictures.
Pictures?
Nevermore. Oh, thank God. Thank God for the theater.
Tonight, live on stage, in person, the one, the only King of Horror, Bela Dracula Lugosi, in his terrifying Midnight Spook Show. See the bloody guillotine, the Batman and the monster in death struggle, the beautiful Goyal burned alive!
Thank God for the theater.
Look now to avoid disappointment. Also showing Bela Lugosi in The Ape Man.
We want the movie.
Please, please don't struggle to be in the rage, Harry. Now, my dear, where we shall see if you are to be the bride of science.
Oh, please, please, don't come any closer.
It is too late for you, my dear. No one can help you. I need your blood. It's what I want, what I must have. Ah! Who threw that? Don't you know who I am?
Mr. Lugosi! What do you mean he walked off?
Just what I'm telling you. Some wise ass threw a fake turd.
Oh,
you know,
geez.
The realistic, sloppy kind. Hit him square in the face.
Oh.
So he flipped and walked off.
Mr. Lugosi! Mr. Lugosi, open the door! Oh, okay, Tony, break it in.
Okay. Go on.
Oh, Mr. Lugosi! Oh, my God!
Is he dead?
Oh, God, oh, God, this is all we need. Tony, get some coffee.
Should we get a doctor?
No, we don't want the publicity. He'll be okay. He's just a little loaded.
So, what's in the syringe? Bourbon?
What? Oh, Jesus, Bella, no! Oh, come on, come on!
Give him a slap! Hey, look at this!
No! Oh, he's there! God!
Oh, Jesus, Bella! Oh, thank God!
Medicine, leave me! Go away! Tell him to go away!
It's morphine!
Oh, Bella, you poor bastard! Who's been giving you this shit? Oh, come on, let's get you walking around, come on! Up you get. Come on, that's it.
Come on.
You're okay. That's it. Tony, where's that coffee?
Okay. Go on, to die. That's right. To be really dead.
Death must be glorious.
I must say, this is an unexpected pleasure. I'm so glad to see you. How are you, Bela? I heard you were ill.
It was nothing. Exhaustion. But I am much better now.
Oh, please excuse my attire. I must look quite a sight. If I knew you were coming, I'd have put some clothes on.
I don't, well...
What a buffoon. The head. The trunks.
You see, I always water my roses in me wickies and top hat. You could say it's another of my strange English customs.
I see.
Now then, to what do I owe the pleasure?
Well, Boris, I...
Don't mind her. She's just nosy. Violet, leave Mr. Lugosi alone. Sorry, you were saying?
Yes, well, they've had an offer to appear in Las Vegas.
Good for you, old boy.
The money is very good. It's a great deal, but there is a catch.
Oh?
You see, they want both of us, Karloff and Lugosi. Together again.
Ah, I see.
Apparently, I'm no good to them on my own.
Nonsense, Bela.
No, it is true. They have made it quite clear.
So you've come here to ask me to do the show with you?
Well, will you? Will you do it?
Bela, look around you. I'm happy here. I have my farm, my garden, my pig, my family. I have enough work, enough money to carry on living this way. I'm sorry, I don't want to go to Las Vegas and do some tacky show. I'm too old, Bela. And to tell you the truth, I don't want to make a fool of myself. Go blast, Violet! Get off, you silly pig! Oh, look, what a mess you've made of me wickies!
You can never trust the Englishmen, my friend. They are fools. So hopeless. So helpless. Come. Come away. You don't need this.
Well, it was just a thought. It doesn't matter really, Boris. I'm too busy myself. As a matter of fact, I've had an offer to take Dracula on the road again. A big tour, the East Coast.
Good for you. Oh, I don't know where you get the stamina.
Virgin's blood. Well, I won't keep you.
Oh, do stay for tea.
Tell him to stick it up his arse.
No, thank you. I I have much to do. Well, goodbye, Boris.
Goodbye, Bela. Good luck. Poor Bela.
Immortality.
I'm tired.
That's your half-hour call, Mr. Lugosi.
Come on. It's your time.
I am Dracula. I am Dracula. I am Dracula. Oh, God, not again. I can't go through this again. Oh, God. Give me strength. Who is it?
It's me. Can I come in?
The blood is the life.
Shut up.
Mr. Lugosi?
My dear. How nice to see you. Please, come in.
Well, I just wanted to pop round, really, and wish everyone good luck for tonight. I left you till last because I wanted to say what an honor it is to be playing opposite you.
The pleasure is all mine, I assure you. Please.
Thank you.
A drink?
Well, I shouldn't really before a show. Well, if you were having one.
I never drink wine before a show.
Oh, Mr. Lugosi, you're terrible.
Yes, but I find the medicinal whiskey serves me well. Cheers.
Cheers. May I ask you something?
Of course. My beautiful Lucy can ask me anything.
You're doing Dracula again, on stage, after all these years. You must really love it.
If only you knew, my dear.
If only you knew.
Sorry?
I don't know whether I should brag or complain about it, but Dracula is the only picture in existence in all the world that is revived in every city in the world every year.
Gee, I didn't know that. So, as a result of Dracula...
I make a living. As a result of Dracula, I'm the boogeyman.
But it must be wonderful.
It is a blessing, and it is a curse. No, it's hell.
But to have all that success, fame... I'm not kidding. I'd sell my soul for a part that could give me what you have. I think I would do anything.
Anything?
Anything.
And yet, who would have thought the old man to have so much blood in him?
What's that from?
Macbeth. Damn, you made me say it. My dear, I'm going to tell you something. I like you. I like you because I trust you. You remind me of me. Eager, thrusting. You are young and strong and vital. It's all in front of you.
Mr. Lugosi, you're staring at my breasts.
Yes. Lovely round orbs of destruction. Don't be alarmed. Let's have another drink.
So tell me, if it's such hell, why are you doing Dracula again?
Look into my eyes.
Yes?
I need the money.
You're kidding.
Ah, the spell is broken.
Will you shut up?
I'm sorry, I...
No. Forgive me. Have another drink. Yes, I am poor. Ex-wives, you know. The same old story.
But surely the movies. You're a big star.
$500 a week.
What?
That's what I get for the motion picture Dracula. Other members of the cast get four times as much. I play the part on stage 3 years. But do they think to ask me when they do the picture? No. Then Janie gets sick, and only then do they come to me. $500 a week. Take it or leave it. I cannot say no. I am less than anyone else on the picture. But I think the role will make me a star. The money is... So here I am. A star. Dracula. The living dead. I sign a contract in ink, but I make a pact in blood.
There. That was easy, wasn't it?
You made me say it.
No. You were ready. That is all.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. Oh, that's awful.
Back in Hungary, I was respected, admired as an actor. I did it all. Shakespeare, you know. Hamlet. I played Romeo. Yes, Romeo. I even played Jesus. I was Jesus. It was my greatest success.
Your greatest success?
Christ. My dear.
Yes?
Will you Go away, please. I need to take my medicine.
At last. It takes you a long time to face up to fiction.
Immortality.
Eternal life. There are such things.
I am so tired. So tired of all this.
Then now is the time, my friend. Come. I have always been part of you. Deny me no more. Deny yourself no more.
But how? How will I be immortal?
By living your life in my shadow. You will exert a fascination from beyond the grave. Your life will be documented in countless books, films, even radio plays. In 50 years' time, your photographs, signatures, and memorabilia will sell more than Karloff's, and second only to that of Marilyn Monroe.
Who?
Oh, my friend. The most famous woman in the world. The greatest sex goddess ever to walk the earth. Another with the power to fascinate in death. You shall walk with her through eternity. But all this is in the future. Here is a picture.
My God, she is beautiful.
In a trashy kind of way.
Wait a minute. What do you get out of this?
You and I are immortal. Dracula will be the biggest selling book next to the Bible. You hear? Never out of print. Not once. Oh, friend Bela, don't you see?
No.
Mention the name of Dracula, and they will see you, not I. You! Immaculate in evening dress, patent leather hair, straight back, cape swirling in the mist. The demon lover who died, yet lived. Oh, my friend. You shall be immortal. I shall be free. You shall set me free. Let me help you to help me.
I will have to die to achieve this.
You will never die, my friend. Not for some time.
How? Are you going to bite me? Drink my blood?
No. As you once said, you are already bitten, my friend. Already my blood flows through your rotten veins. Your blood is as black as my sins. You are sick, my friend, but I shall make you well. Come, embrace me. Embrace me. Embrace me. This is your blood.
This is your blood I drink.
This is my body.
This is my body you eat.
I am the dark.
I am the dark prince whose communion is the blood of virgins. I am Christ, risen from the grave. I wear my crown of horns. I sleep in my coffin. Judas, would you betray me with a stake through the heart? I am Dracula, on the cross, dying for my sins night after night after night. The crowd are on their feet, an ovation. They fear me. They love me. They adore me. They worship me. Very well. I will thirst again. I will drink your blood once again. I will embrace you with my kiss of death. For one who has not lived even a single lifetime, I am a wise man, Van Helsing.
Thank you.
Mr. Lugosi, we all know you as Dracula.
I only played it once, you know.
On screen?
Yes, the original Dracula. Only time I play that role in a picture.
Well, I'll be. I could have
sworn... Dracula never ends. It never ends.
Quite. But what I want to know is, are there any other types of roles that you would like to play? A romantic part, perhaps?
At 66, I'm too old for the romantic, but interesting you should say. I've always wanted to play comedy.
My word, that's quite a picture.
Yes, it is a much more challenging type of part. I want to get away from the horror parts. There is so much more that I would like to do. In fact, soon I realize my dream.
Really?
In 2 weeks, I start work on a new comedy at Universal.
Is this with Deanna Durbin?
No, it is with two very funny men.
Abbott and Costello.
Yes, a funny boy.
What's the picture called?
Abbott and Costello meet Frankenstein.
But isn't the monster dead?
No, 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 no. It never dies. It's alive.
Of course. It's indestructible.
Exactly.
So, it's Abbott and Costello meet Frankenstein. And who do you play?
I am Dracula.
Just a moment, ladies and gentlemen. Just a word before you go. We hope the memories of Lugosi and Dracula won't give you bad dreams. So just a word of reassurance. When you go to bed tonight and the lights have been turned out and you are afraid to look behind the curtains and you dread to see a face appear at the window, why, just pull yourself together and remember that after all, there are such things.
I am Dracula.
Amen.
There Are Such Things was written and performed by Mark McDonnell and Stephen McNichol with Julie Duncanson and Gavin Hamilton. The play was directed in Edinburgh by Patrick Rayner.